Hi everybody, today we are going to study next point in a set. So we have next point power set. Okay, now what is the definition of power set? First we see that definition is the collection of all subsets of a set A is called power set of A, and it is denoted by P of A, capital P of A. For example, if we see example A is equal to 1, 2, 3, so we have to find power set of A. That is, to find power set of A, by definition it is the collection of all subsets of a set A. Okay, now we have to find the subsets of set A. So here the power set of A can be defined as, or it will contain the sets. First set, it will be empty set, because every empty set is subset of any set. Okay, next we will define single elements sets of A. So here 1 is a single element, so first set will be single 1, second element will be singleton 2, 3. Okay, all elements are here completed, 1, 2, and 3. Now we consider pairs. So first we consider 1 and 2 as a set. Next we consider 1, 3 as a set. Okay, now we consider, so 1, 2 and 2, 1 are same, so we define 1, 2. Okay, now for 2 there are possible 2, 1 is over, because 1, 2 set and 2, 1 set is same, so there is only possibility 2, 3. Okay, there are 3 sets with 2 elements. Okay, now itself, every set is itself a subset. So here A is a subset of itself, so the power set, or we can write here a set, we take to the next line here 1, 2, 3. Okay, so which is A. Okay, so the power set of A has the elements empty set, singles element 1, single element 2, single element 3, or we can say that singleton set 1, 2, 3. Now we consider pair possibilities 1, 2, 1, 3, next 2, 3, 3, 2 is same as 2, 3 set, so it is not taken. Next, all possibilities of 2 elements are over. Next 3 is only one possibility, 1, 2, 3, and is equal to A. Also, we note that the cardinality, or n of P of A, is equal to here number of elements are 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Here power set is equal to 8, is equal to 2 raised to 3. Okay, and number of element in a set A is equal to 3, so 2 cube is equal to 8. What do we mean? First we have to define cardinality of, which is cardinality of set. Its definition is number of elements in a set A, or in a set A, is called cardinality. of set. Okay, and it is denoted by notation is n of A, or it also written as mod of A. Okay, there are two notations. Okay, we use here n of A. N of power set of A is equal to 2 cube. Okay, now consider again next example. If we have an example A is equal to AB, okay, and find power set of A. We have to find power set of A. So here A contains, or n of A is equal to 2. Okay, then P of A, n of P of A is equal to, it will be 2 raised to 2, which is equal to 4. That is, power set of A contains 4 element. Okay, I will give remark after this example. So power set of A is equal to, first we start from empty set, next element, so single element, consider set of single element, singleton set A, singleton set B, and now consider two element sets. A comma B itself is a single set, is equal to A. No other possibility is there, because BA is same as AB, which is A sets itself set. So n of P of A, there are number of elements 1, 2, 3 and 4. So we get n of P of A is equal to 4. Remark, if a cardinality of A, that is number of element in a set A, has k elements, that is A contains, set A contains k elements, then n of P of A is equal to 2 raised to k. Okay, then n of P of A is equal to 2 raised to k, that is power set of A contains 2 raised to k elements. Okay, now next point is universal set, which is universal set. Okay, in any applications of a set theory, all sets under study are regarded as subset of a fixed set. This fixed set is called as universal set and is denoted by capital U. That is, for example, in a study of certain college, the universal set is a set of all students in that college. This is first example of universal set. Or we can study in a plane geometry. The universal set is the set of all points in a plane. Okay, these are some example of a universal set. Now consider a next point, operation on a sets. In that, first operation is complement of a set. First operation is complement of a set. In which a definition is, the complement of a set A denoted by A raised to C or A dash is the set of elements which does not belongs to elements which does not belongs to set A. A complement is equal to X such that X belongs to U, comma, X does not belongs to A. Okay? It should not be belongs to A, but belongs to U. U means universal set, which is universal set. Okay? For example, if we take U is equal to 1 to 10, U is equal to set 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 10. A is equal to set of odd integers of U, which is equal to set of odd integers are 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9 are all odd integers. Therefore, A complement will be, A complement is equal to remaining elements of U. Here 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 are present in A. So 1 does not belongs to A complement. So next element is 2. 3 is there. Next 4. 5 is in A. So it does not belongs to A complement. Next element is 6. 7 is there. 8. 9 is there. And 10. After that there is no element. So our A complement will be 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. Okay. This is complement of A. Next definition is relative complement. The relative complement of a set B with respect to set A denoted by A minus B or A slash B is the set of elements which are in A but not in B. Okay, this is definition of A minus B or relative complement. So it also written in the form A minus B is equal to set X such that X belongs to A and X does not belongs to B. Okay, X should be present in A but not in B. Such type of element will be present in A minus B, or which also written as A slash B. Okay. For example, we take here A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, B is equal to 2, 3, 4, 5 and C is equal to 3, 4, 5, 6. So A minus B is equal to, A minus B is equal to, here it is element X such that X belongs to A but does not belongs to B. Here if we consider 1, 1 is present in A but not in B. So A minus B, it can be written as 1. Okay. Next, 2 is present in A, 2 is present in B also. So it cannot be written in A minus B. 3 is present in both set. We have condition X belongs to A but not belongs to B. So we have to write only such elements which are present in A but not in B. Here 2, 3 and 4 are present in B. So there is only one element in set A minus B. Now in B minus A, if we check B minus A, here 2, 3 and 4 are present in A. Okay, 2, 3 and 4 are present in A. Now remaining element 5 is not present in A. So we can write B minus A as 5. Okay, B minus A is equal to singleton element 5. Now here we don't write 1 because 1 is not present in B. We have to write an element which should be present in that set, first set. Okay. Now A minus C. Now elements of A which are present in C. Now 1 is not present in C, so we can write A minus C as 1. Next element 2, it is also not present in C, so it can be written as element in A minus C. Next 3 and 4 are present in C, so there are only two elements in A minus C. Now for C minus A, we have to check an elements from C which does not present in A. So here 3 and 4 are present in A and 5 and 6 are absent, so C minus A will be 5, 6. Okay, if we find B minus C is equal to, now from B minus C, here 3, 4, 5 from B is present in C, only element 2 is not present in C, so B minus C will be 2, and C minus B is equal to, C minus B will be 3, 4, 5 is present in B, 6 is not present in B, so C minus B is equal to 6. Okay, this all are known as relative complements. Here B, a relative complement of B with respect to A is A minus B. Okay, here relative complement of C with respect to A is A minus C. Here relative complement of C with respect to B is equal to 2. Okay, from in definition it is given, a relative complement of set B with respect to set A is denoted by A minus B. Now if we consider A minus of B minus C, okay, now here B minus C is 2, okay, and A elements are 1, 2, 3, 4. Now in A minus B minus C, here B minus C is in bracket, so B minus C is set, single set 2. So we have to find relative complement of B minus C to the respect to set A. Okay, here only 2 is present in B minus C, remaining element from A are absent in B minus C, so the set A minus B minus C will be 1, 3, 4. Okay, similarly if we find B minus C minus A, which gives, in this C minus A is 5, 6, and in B there are elements 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, only 5 is present in this both. Okay, C minus A and B. Okay, now else element 2, 3 and 4 are not present in C minus A, so B minus of C minus A will be 2, 3, 4. Okay, so you can solve such type of examples. Next point is union of two sets. The union of two sets A and B denoted by A union B, U capital, or it is notation of union, is the set of elements which are in A or in B. Okay, that is A union B is equal to X, such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B. That is, X should be present in one of the set or both sets. Okay, if it is present in both sides, we have to write it once only. For example, if we consider A is equal to set 1, 2, 3, 4 and B is equal to set 3, 4, 5, 8. Okay, then A union B will be, A union B will be, first write elements from set A 1, 2, 3, 4. Next we write remaining elements from set B. 3 and 4 is here written because it is present in A, so we don't write it again. Now remaining elements are 5 and 8. Okay, so this will be our A union B. All elements from A and B are present in A union B. Okay, and here if we remark, can be written as A is always subset of A union B and B is also subset of A union B. Okay, next definition is intersection of two sets. It is the intersection of two sets A and B denoted by by A intersection B is the set of elements which are in A and B. That is, it should be present in both sets A and B. That is, A intersection B is equal to X such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B. That is, this X will be present in both set A and B. So, for example, we take above example as, so its intersection will be, now the common element from both two sets A and B are, I think 3 and 4 are common element from both sets A, B. So intersection will be A intersection B is equal to 3, 4. Okay. Now consider next example. If we consider A is equal to A, B, C, D, E and B is equal to D, E, G, H and I. So its union will be A union B is equal to A, B, C, D, E. Now elements from B, D, E is present in, we have written it. So next element G, H and I, G, H and I. So A union B will be elements from both the two sets. A intersection B is equal to, intersection will be common elements from both is D, E. Okay. And A minus B is equal to, now here A minus B is equal to, here A, B, C, A is not present in B, okay, B also not present in B, next C is not present in B, next D, E, D, E is present, so A minus B will be A, B and C, and B minus A will be a set of, now from B, we have X belongs to B but does not belongs to A. Now D is present in A, E is present in A, next G is present in B but absent in A. So B minus A will be G, next H is present in B but absent in A. So we write H, next I is present in B and absent in A. So G, H and I is a set of B minus A. Okay, such types of examples are related to operations of a set. Okay, so in these operations we have seen complement of sets, next relative complement of a set, next union of a set, intersection of a set. Okay, in next lecture we will define Venn diagram and draw the Venn diagram related to all these operations. Okay, thank you.